Hello everyone, welcome back to Dota Pit, game number two between Power Rangers and Team Liquid. As you see, I've got the full crew with me tonight.
I was on the phone trying to sort out my Super Bowl night.
Yes, and I was here to make things more serious.
I'm so hyped right now though, G2A.com, I can't wait to go home and buy some video games. They are cheap as duck.
That's right everybody, Dota Pit brought to you by G2A.
Please, not too many memes.
Anyway, let's talk about the draft. Zeus Inspector, I wonder what Power Rangers are going for here.
The global strategy. And speaking of other things that start with G.
I'm just messing. We're done. All right, we're good. We're good. That was our only joke
Team
for the night.
I'm sure
we could fit in some more.
No, that's just a strong combination. It's a good opener. If you're going to take one, they're going to ban the other, so you have to sort of pair it.
Yeah.
To be fair, Liquid can still outdo the global strat by picking up like Ancient Apparition and the Nature's Prophet.
Yeah. I think AA is one of the better heroes too, against both Zeus and Spectre.
Is that how you do it? In order to beat two globals, you get three globals?
Oh yeah. Like whenever the old MYM and Dota 1 would fight against SK, we would just be like, it was a race to who could get the most global. So if they went for the Zeus Spectre, you could bet your head on us going for the Nature's Prophet, the Beastmaster, and the Tinker.
This is just what Dota was back then. Just everybody would just try to do the same strat but slightly better.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, I don't know what everyone else did, but obviously people want to copy the best, and so they followed what I did.
I still can't believe that Jacob was a good captain in Dota 1.
You know, Blitz is actually talking about before you got here. He's like, I think I started the meme that Jacob is, you know, not involved with Dota at all, and he's not good.
Yeah.
When in reality, I'm actually one of the brightest minds in the industry.
You know, it's so easy to shut you down just because you're so arrogant about it. You know, sometimes I feel bad, and I'm just like, I was like, man, the Dota community really rags on Jacob when the reality is he's really, really smart and knows a lot about Dota.
Yeah, he's got top
and then he's like, I'm the best at everything, and I'm just like, whatever.
It's because the plebs find him super unlikable, and I don't know why.
They did go for the counter global, though. They have a Wisp. They have a Darkseer.
Mm-hmm.
This is a hero that I almost never see being given up to teams that specialize in it, the Wisp. Because that hero just, it takes so much map control by itself. Team pick.
But there's a little bit too much to ban. Obviously, you can't let him have Earth Spirit. And Lone Druid's just a bit too strong right now. Juggernaut and OD going to be banned away by Power Rangers. So there's not too many mids left to go up against the Zeus. Still no Death Prophet being seen here. And we do have a potential team fight. So there it is. Death Prophet. Dire team pick.
This also shows how highly these teams, how they rate the supports. With Vengeful Spirit coming out, you see the Oracle ban and the Witch Doctor ban. I'm surprised that Witch Doctor is that high up on the ban list.
Witch Doctor... It's really good against the IO. That's the main thing. It's really good against the Wisp.
Yeah.
It's one of the most annoying supports. It's hard to play around, too, because you want free space to tether.
That being said, I don't think they should have banned away Oracle. Or at least I personally don't think that's a strong ban. I think the Ancient Apparition would have been, or Venge, actually, would have been better ban against if they're going to plan on third pick DP. Because Oracle actually works really well with Death Prophet as well. If you still had an option to be able to get it, I'd be all over it.
Well, the thing is, it's also really good against the Darkseer, so you couldn't risk it, right?
Oh, that's true.
Oh, that's true, yeah.
I forgot about that. Good call.
Yeah. The Darkseer just gets so hard countered by it. Like, you take the Darkseer because it's good against the spec, both in the lane and later on in the game, but if you just have some guy just purging off your Ion Shell every few seconds, it's pretty miserable to play against.
Yeah.
It's part of it, too, because teams will just first two pick Oracle and then... It's like, okay, you can't take Darkseer anymore. But because Power Rangers, they already open with Zeus spec, the DS option is open.
So presumably you want a little AoE control, right, to go with this Darkseer? And you've got the sustain between the mech coming out of him, the push with the Death Prophet. You also need... I mean, I wouldn't mind Sven here as their carry for Team Liquid.
I think both Tiny and Sven works really well, depending on what they want to do. I think for the actual tower pushing... Sven right now is just slightly better because of the armor buff.
Mm-hmm.
With God Strength, he obviously takes down the tower almost as fast as a Tiny with an Aghanim Scepter would. So I do favor Sven just because of how good he is this version, but we all know how just how strong Wisp and Tiny can be.
Enchantress. So Enchant is the hero here. This hero has been rising up like crazy as of late. People are starting to realize how good Untouchable is, completely paired with your ultimate in the later phase of the game. It works pretty well against Spectre. You can put a lot of pressure down. Power Rangers is going to be mostly on the defensive because they have a spec. Like this hero, the way that people play it, it comes online a little bit faster, but it's still, the laning phase has to kind of go okay.
What do you think about the lanes, though? Is this actually going to be still the Enchantress paired up with the Darkseer? Because normally when Enchantress is paired up with a hero like Abaddon, Spirit Breaker, one of those tankier frontline heroes for Enchantress, it's because you want to be able to get the farm on Enchant.
I think they're going to go for a jungle Enchantress and then put on a lot of early pressure and really try and win all the lanes against Power Rangers. And I think Power Rangers has a huge issue right now. I think they need to commit to either a huge team fight setup with either a Tidehunter or an Earthshaker for the offlane. Otherwise, they might find themselves being pushed by Team Liquid. Team Liquid feels like the clockwork because it has that tiny global perspective. But I really think Team Liquid could sort of death ball and push very early on, and there was very little Power Rangers could actually do about it, just because the Vengeful Spirit pretty much does nothing against the push. And if the AA isn't 6, or if you're already tanky enough to live through the level 1 ultimate because Power Rangers can't dish out enough damage early on, then Team Liquid can easily enter base with around the 20-minute mark. And I think that's something the Power Rangers need to focus on right now, making sure that their offlaner is the teamfight-oriented hero.
I think PR's lineup, it's not as well balanced. I feel like AA is okay, but I almost just feel like he's just going to be abused before he can really get online. Like, the AA ults, every time I look at it, I'm just like, that spell's amazing, but I don't know.
This is an all-in from Power Rangers, trying to, instead of Team Liquid winning the lanes, obviously Power Rangers wanting to win the lanes and just establish this gank potential all around the map and just hope that they can preemptively stop Team Liquid's push before it even gathers up.
I do like Nyx's Assassin. Solely for the mana burn at this point in time. You've actually got 4 heroes that are susceptible to the nukes of Nyx Assassin, particularly that mana burn against Death Prophet and Enchantress. The Darkseers obviously has a pretty big mana pool as well.
They just needed a setup hero. Like, you needed something that could get around the map and open things up, because you don't want to, again, when you have a hero like Spectre, it's counterintuitive because this hero can go so late game, but you want something that can set it up, use the early haunts to full effect, and this is a hero that we haven't seen.
I actually sort of like this pickup. I think Power Rangers are lacking AoE and control against the Chaos Knight, so that even if this goes late, it still favors Team Liquid. I still think Sven and Tiny would have been equally strong, but if there ever was a game for a Chaos Knight pick, I think this could very well be it.
It's a cool idea. I just want to see how it goes. I think PR can sort of deal with it. They've got AA Blast, Nyx stun, Zeus. This Zeus, though, has to be a lot more successful than he was in Game 1. But the laning phase is even harder against a DP.
Yeah, I can't imagine any hero that punishes Zeus more. Maybe a Viper.
No, I think against Viper, you can just sit back. Like, DP beats everybody. I think there are very few heroes that DP just loses 1-1 against.
And they have no real good roaming potential to help out the Zeus in this matchup.
Yeah. You need help. I kind of want to see, actually, the AA. This is the issue. Like, if they had taken a Bane or something, maybe they could just establish mid control for the Zeus a little and help him out. But with the heroes that you have, if you sack the AA and put him in the mid lane, I don't know if Venge Spectre is enough to zone out the Darkseer by himself, right?
Right. Talk about a little bit more about what is it about Chaos Knight that makes him, because we rarely see him, he feels a bit more specialized. What does he give us that Sven, Tiny, even Wraith King, you know, what those heroes don't give?
I think you don't need a BKB as soon as the other ones. There's some mobility. It's hard to just stop him as it is for the other two. Like, for Tiny, he really relies on the burst. But then after that, a hero like Spec, if he can survive it, he can go toe-to-toe with you. And I think Sven just gets kited a little bit too much.
A nice, quick first blood, it looks like, for Liquid. Yeah, goes over to Shaq.
Oh, that's huge.
They implemented a very sneaky little smoke, walked all the way around. Caught the Enchantress sitting on the cliff.
That's actually so much gold for Shaq.
Oh, Cheshire Cat, though, he somehow got caught in that bottom lane despite seeing them earlier. He is actually going to go down here, it looks like. Despite Carapace plus Fairy Fire, he does have another Mango, though. Cheshire Cat's going to have to juke it as much as possible. 2 second stun again. And Cheshire Cat, he's going to be blocked out. He still has a Tango. Maybe he can use his way through, but no. Matumba Man with a big swipe finally claims that kill. Still, though, the first blood was picked up by Power Rangers, so really not that big of a loss for the Nyx Assassin. He can still get himself out to lane. In fact, it's going to be the Chaos Knight and Whisper going to be missing for a little bit.
It's a pretty big loss in terms of consumables, though.
Yeah, it's true. Oh, J4 hoping to be able to block out Mind Control, but he just eats through the tree and gets away.
That first blood impacts a lot, though. It helps the Zeus so much. Mm-hmm. He should have his bottle straight away with that, I believe.
And it helps out Illidan quite a bit, too, because Darkseer chose to go for the Surge in order to try and save the Enchantress.
He has to play a lot greedier now. That's why he was in the side, but then he got scouted out by the two supports.
Mm-hmm.
He's like, I have to get my level 2.
Did Fader not skill the Soul Drain on level 1 when he found that pick?
He got Spirit Siphon.
He just didn't want to. He didn't think it was necessary. Because the cooldown on it is so long, the refresh time, that you don't want to. If you can, you should save it for the mid lane. And he was pretty confident that they were going to get the kill, and they ended up getting it right. It just made it a little dicier than he had considered.
J4.
Oh, no.
Getting clapped on. Mind Control gets a couple right clicks. So he's actually going to send the Hellbear Smasher in for a little bit more. Hellbear Smasher, 5 second cooldown here. Big Dumb doesn't have a stun. They really need to get this clap, and they will be able to get the kill on J4 if it lands. But, oh, it's just a bit too far away. Now the healing salve comes into play.
I don't think he would have died either. Playing a lot of these neutral creeps. I think he needed too many hits after the clap.
Yeah, I agree. He had the Tango already running on him for the heal. Imagine if he had the Ion Shell, though.
Unfortunately, that wasn't up yet now.
He's level 2, though.
He is level 2, soon to be level 3.
Look how annoying this is for their safe lane. It's so little that they can do against this. Matumba Man's just going to go in and bottom again. Is he only level 1? Yeah.
Yeah, he has no stun to be able to stop this kind of aggression. Finally picks it up, will be able to turn around and get a stun on Kuro, but doesn't seem to mean too much. Jerix, meanwhile, pushing back Shaq, not allowing him to be able to get much control. Ideally, they'll be able to stop that 4-minute rune as well. But
what they're trying to do there is, it's not even about killing him, it's that he doesn't get the lane of XP. When you push in the lane like that, it's unfortunate because the Wisp isn't going to really be able to leave the lane. But you want to at least make it so that when the creep wave does push up like that, the Nyx doesn't just get a free camp and a half.
Right. Speaking of lanes pushing in, they are going to try and zone out Mind Control. He desperately wants to be able to get up this ramp and around, but it looks a little too dangerous for him. And this camp of melee creeps is actually going to go to waste. Mind Control won't be able to pick it up in time.
That's so unfortunate. It's so huge for the offlaner to be able to get the free XP when the lane pushes in. But both teams are doing a really good job of denying out. And now look, the DP just sits on the high ground. Shaq can't do anything, even with the first blood gold that he had.
Now the Ion Shell spamming has begun. Illidan still going for that popular Batman build. Phase boots, earn drums.
You could say he heals Batman.
You're so stupid.
Shaq. It's going to be run down by the Wisp and Fada. His Spirit Siphon wasn't enough. Boost up the Death Prophet's movement speed just a bit more with Tether. And it just is impossible for that mid laner to be able to get away.
The downside, though, is that this Nyx is getting a lot during this time period, but I think Liquid's game plan is to make this DP as effective as possible in the early game. Now Mind Control's getting up a little bit more farm.
Oh, they got the stun out on him. Illidan, yep, they're going to be able to run him down. Desolate damage coming in big, and that'll be a little bit of a boost to the Spectre's farm. Meanwhile, bottom lane, Cheshire Cat tries to pick up the rune, but is denied here, and Kuro hoping to be able to slow him down enough. But coming across, Fada's actually going to be able to catch Shaq here with the Spirit Siphon. Shaq is not going to be able to run away. The Wisp, again, that tether movement speed, and Shaq knows it too. Nothing he can do against that combination, so he just throws down whatever nukes he can.
So the only saving grace in the early game for PR right now is the fact that Bignum on the Vengeful Spirit did such a good job at zoning out the Mind Control on the Darkseer. And going into the mid game, they really gonna rely a lot on this AA turning level 6 and hitting his ultimate because of all the heal that comes out from Wisp Enchantress and of course the Siphon Zone.
Yeah, you're right there.
Looks like they're gonna try and set up for another kill on Mind Control.
This is pretty huge.
Come in on all three sides. Surge popped, but they get the stun if they could body block him just a little bit. Oh, unfortunately the Cold Feet's not gonna go down. Illidan's still gonna run him down though. The Vase Boots pick up. Seems like they've got it. Yep, the dagger comes out, finish them off. The TP in. Matumba Man's going to try and pull back. Illidan still has that extra movement speed from the dagger, though. The stun comes out. Matumba Man not. Oh, maybe with the Orb of Venom, Illidan actually might not be able to escape this one. Phase Boots dodging around. He's going to have to eat through the trees, but has no escape. Bignum has to walk back through that tier 1 tower. Meanwhile, in the middle lane, Shaq run down again. Shaq, this is just not his series, man. Every single time he's in a matchup against Fauna, that is too favorable to Fauna, especially now with the Roaming Wisp.
That has got to be so demoralizing. Every time you show up to the lane, dead.
Yeah.
It's really one of those moments where you just start pinging the map a ton and just spam out well played.
Like, what are you going to do, though? So they go on top, right? Yeah. And that's going to be Liquid Signal to go because they know that the Venge can't be there and they know that the AA isn't going to contribute anything. So they decide to dive in deep for that Zeus. It was just an unfortunate circumstance.
Have TP.
Yeah.
That's all he can do, actually. And that is something that he has been lacking. If he had TP in any of the scenarios, because they don't have stuns between their supports, and obviously DP doesn't have a stun either.
If he gets nuked once, and then they decide to go on him, though, he'll just die.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just, it's a really hard lane.
But you still need that option. J4, he's definitely dead. In fact, Fada, or Matumba Man actually just leaving and trying to catch Shaq as well. 7-3, Liquid taking very early control of this game.
I mean, to underline just how poorly it's going for Shaq, he is the same level as the supports on his own team.
He's just being dived nonstop. Yeah. He can't really... You can't survive, though. I don't know what I would do differently in this situation, because you're a Zeus. You still need to lane. But he lost his tower so soon, and his safe lane is being aggroed so hard. Like, mind control dying like that is okay, because he's putting a lot of pressure and forcing both supports to be up there. The one thing that's going pretty well for PR is that their Nyx is about to hit level 6, and he can make a lot happen. Like, this is what's going to change. But you also need the level 6 on the AA before you do anything. Once you get those two things, that's when you can start talking about the game. And if Liquid still run them over at that point, then you start to panic a little bit. But before you get 6 on both these heroes, like, I don't know. I'll go to AA. AA is level 4, alright. But as soon as he hits 6, then... And you can start talking about the game.
Dire's bottom tower has fallen. Unfortunately, that is still not here, and yet another tier 1 tower is down for Power Rangers. They do have their level 6 on Illidan, still winning on the other two, though. Is under attack.
I think you just keep going if you're Liquid. You just take a quick glance at the levels, say nobody's level 6 on their team, why not Dire's keep going? Cheshire Cat has the Void Ease.
Tier 2. Seems to be forfeit. Cheshire poking his head out. But really, he's just soaking experience at this point.
So the best that you can do in this scenario, your team can't TP and help you. The Zeus is such a low level that it's not really a threat, right, for him to come in. So you just give this tower up, show the Venge. Maybe they don't think the Nyx is there then. Nyx is about to hit level 6. Zeus is about to hit level 6 too. Which isn't great, but it's the best that you're going to get out of this scenario.
At this point in time, what does Liquid do to just control their leads? Because they know Nyx Assassin is going to be roaming around. Do you just continue to five-man?
Put up the deep wards, make sure the Enchantress is staying on the Dire side of the map, and then have the Wisp relocate.
That's pretty much it. I mean, you just keep playing more aggressively. You use the strength as a DP. There's no hero right now that PR can that can really do anything to her. She's got treads. She's about to get a Yule Scepter. You sort of just have to play back if you're PR. Liquid just continue to take out all the outer towers.
And it's really important that Liquid sticks together, because the only way that PR is even going to get back into this game is by Nyx picking up kills on his own with the... Well, when I say on his own, they have this global backup for him, so whenever he finds a target that is sort of on his own, either an AA Blast, Zeus Ultimate, Spectre Ultimate, there's a lot of things that can set it up for him to ensure that kill through Vendetta. So... Unless he picks off the Enchantress on his own. See, there's the relocate.
They're still going to catch him. The haste, and yeah. relocate in. Crow's actually on a killing spree, and that's going to be the last of the tier 1 towers. Forfeit, Power Rangers. All they can really do is counter push somewhere else. They're actually trying to go for the quick kill on the Wisp. Cheshire Cat is here, leans up with a stun, still has that Spike Carapace if he wants to be able to stun Crow a little bit longer. Has the extra damage coming in from the Zeus, though, and they will finally be able to get themselves a kill.
Kill is a kill at this point. It doesn't really matter who you get it on. Just kind of getting your foot back in the game. They also got a kill on a killing spree Wisp. They were able to set up a little bit. That helps out the Zeus, makes him tilt a little bit less. If you're PR, though, the problem right now is that you notice that the Spectre gank, I almost feel like that was a little bit obvious, but it's not a hero that can move around. It's really static. Like, what is he going to do? Go to the offlane or to the mid where you've already lost your tower? Mm-hmm. You can't really protect him at that point. And he's really susceptible to the Wisp CK. So you go to the safe lane. Maybe the only way that you stop that is if your team is completely set up. But they all just hit level 6. So now you can kind of protect the Spectre. And this is a really important fight to take. If they lose this fight, then you lose most control of your jungle. But if you can win this fight, then you get some control back. You can slow down the timings and create a little bit more space for your team.
Some of the heroes are still low. They have the Spectre going to be coming in. Quick pick off there on Jerix. And rest of Liquid, only some of them, like Matumba Man, are looking a bit low. Ice Blast a bit late to the fight. And Liquid with a relatively clean escape.
I think Liquid made the right decision letting Kuro TP back on his own with the relocate. Just because they could have brought the CK and have the DP TP in to ensure that the Wisp wouldn't go down, because they must have anticipated that there was a high probability of him dying with, to the Vendetta and the follow-up from rest of PR. But they also knew that they were going to get a free tier 2 tower, so the trade-off is just worth it, basically.
Illidan going to be a quick target here from Matumba Man. Gets 2 seconds stun out. Bignum doesn't have a swap, but he will get a stun on Matumba. They can get this Ice Blast. Oh, it's going to be low. Zeus has brought them just inches away from death, but Illidan's not going to be able to run him down for enough damage. 3 seconds stun, and sure enough, even a relocate out to make sure Matumba Man does indeed survive.
Oh, that was so rough. If they get that kill, they can turn things around. The Spec doesn't die there if he can get the 2-mana AA blast off.
Mm-hmm. At least Cheshire Cat got a pick off.
Ironically, if the Enchantress hadn't died to the Vendetta right there, they could have pushed the base tower. There was no Zeus ultimate. Spectre was dead for 30 seconds. They were standing right outside the base.
Instead, they might be able to get some damage on the tier 2 mid.
So Liquid, all they need to do is just stick together and push as 5, or at very best, stick around as 3 and then have Wisp and CK relocate into the fight.
I think that's a better play. You don't want to give the Spectre too much space. This is still a hero that can take it late. When you know you have like the unquestioned best like gamer, then you're always feeling somewhat okay. Matumba Man's getting really
the ice
low.
Blast. They clipped him, and that will bring him down. Spectre managed to pick up the kill too. That's incredibly important. If he can actually get a little bit more here, Kuro does not have a relocate up yet, but he does have a tether to the side. Mind Control is going to give him a little bit of a helping hand. And with the surge, maybe Illidan pops his ultimate. Still has the opportunity to run him down. Dagger doesn't hit on Kuro, but he starts cycling down Mind Control. Cheshire Cat making his way through. Does have the Spike Carapace, but he's going to go straight for Kuro first. Does have the opportunity to just pop him. Now Fada's in the middle of this fight with the Yule Scepter. Will be able to get his hands on Shaq. Instant kill there. The rest of Power Rangers, though, will be able to escape. Illidan with the dagger out. And Nyx Assassin with the TP away.
That was great. They only lost their Zeus. In return, they got the CK and the Wisp. They were able to save their tier 2 tower. At some point, you're going to have to kind of do this last stand where you're like, okay, we can't just give up every single tier 2 because then they'll just Roshan and high ground us and get too much map control. So I like that they took that fight. The problem, though, is that Liquid is just going to do it all over again. Dire's middle
tower is under attack. Yeah, they can afford to be relentless in their pushing and keep chipping away at these tier 2 towers until eventually they should have enough farm to try and break high ground. And it's... I think... They just need some more items on the CK, basically, so that Phantasm comes into play. Because that's really one of those, alongside the Ghost, of course, from the Death Prophet, that's really what they need in order for them to destroy the buildings fast. But Cheshire Cat is doing a great job on the Nyx Assassin so far, setting up the kills and having PR still be in the game.
Yeah, this is two essentially losing games for Power Rangers, where Cheshire Cat has still managed to shine through.
It's just hard when your team loses this much map control this early on. the first death I don't think should have happened for him. And then on top of that, the Wisp just rotated out and abused that Zeus. That was so important for all of this to happen. The DP getting that far ahead.
So itemized, Mind Control's going to be picking up his mech soon. Fada with the BKB, Jerix, Dragonlance for him coming in pretty soon. Girl probably just needs a Glimmer Cape at this point against the Zeus. Meanwhile, on the side of Power Rangers, we only really have Aether Lens. Of course, Spectre's still going, has actually finished up the stat builds, at least for the early game. Illidan's farm is not that bad. Obviously, those kills sincerely helped.
It's not, and right now, Enchantress really, really struggles against this lineup.
There's another pickoff! It will be taken by the Zeus. They still have a little bit more, though. They seem a Tumba man. They've got the Ice Blast on him, too. He's going to be clipped by that one. Cheshire Cat. Oh, they just take him out there. Big mistake by Matumba man, thinking he could actually save Kuro.
Oh, they could get this kill on... Oh, okay.
They're not going to go
they
for
no
it.
Angle.
Yeah, maybe they will. Cheshire Cat thinks he still has the opportunity to catch something here. And he does, too. If he can hit a stun here, he's got Big Num. Going to go for a dive behind the Tier 1 tower. He lands the Impale. Follow up from Big Num. Do they have enough right-click damage, though? May not. With the mech coming in, Jerix is now going to be able to provide some turnaround damage. Swap goes out. Kuro able to provide some assistance. Big Num on his way away, but Fada's already picked up the Nyx Assassin. And in the end, Power Rangers simply way overextend themselves.
Still, good pickoffs by them. Being able to kill the CK once again. This is going to allow the Spectre to get a little bit more ahead. The CK just isn't as far ahead as he should be because he's coming with his team to secure the fights for
whoa,
them.
Whoa, relocate in. Got a quick pickoff there on the Zeus. Illidan going to try and get over the cliff. He'll be okay.
This has just not been Shaq's day.
No. Been picking on him constantly.
Still, not terrible for PR. Again, like I said, the spec hasn't had to really just be there the entire time. He's just coming in for the quick picks. And this is what's going to allow him to kind of stabilize. Like, he's already ahead of the other two cores on Liquid.
What do you think of the Armlet pickup on the Chaos Knight? I mean, he doesn't have it yet, but he's clearly building into it.
Against the AA, it's kind of rough, but it still benefits your illusions, doesn't it?
Don't you think it would have been better to go for any kind of Saints build-up?
SNY?
Yeah, anything that has the early strength gain that isn't an Armlet because of the AA and Zeus.
I was thinking about that too, because I was wondering, it's like, okay, do you go BKB, do you go SNY? Do you go Armlet? There's some questions to be had. Maybe it's the 20-minute Midas. Hee-hee.
Smoke gank up. Vedetta on through the jungle. Power Rangers really hoping to be able to get another pickoff for Spectre to benefit from.
You need to play aggressively like this to get your spec involved without having to necessarily waste too much of his time. So you send your teammates in like Cheshire Cat, who doesn't need a lot of farm to be able to do too much. Unfortunately, they're just going to blink this one.
Yeah. Liquid pretty clearly knew what was going on.
I think what Liquid could be doing is, as soon as Fader finishes the Black King bar, they can start pushing high ground, and instead of having CK stand in the front the entire time, just have him and Darkseer sort of wave in the back while the Dragonlance from Enchantress and the DP slowly but surely takes down the towers, and then PR eventually needs to fight, right? I mean, all they have to really defend themselves with is Zeus until the fight breaks out. So eventually, when they do want to engage, they can then rely on CK and Darkseer to set up the fight for them.
It's okay, though. PR's lineup, they can do an okay job of holding. Because if you mess up against PR's lineup, you get clipped by an AA ult, spec ult, Zeus ult. That's a lot of damage. There's not a whole lot of heroes that can survive that. You're noticing that even the CK just goes down quite quickly with 1400 HP. I think it's going to take a minimum of the BKB on the DP. You should definitely go for the Aegis before anything. Radiant's bottom tower. You can do it too with Enchant.
We're going to go for a quick pickoff here on Illidan. Big Num's here for the swap. But oh, Silence comes out from Fada. They control him up. And actually going
to
try and go for more here with the Gold
Scepter.
Ice Blast is coming in, but it's not actually going to hit him. Shaq still trying to make his way out with a Haste Rune. They do have Illidan now here. Fada's low enough. They can actually get the kill, but Siphon. Oh, now the Meg, and Fada's going to be able to turn this one around. Illidan, he's done for. And there goes three from Power Rangers. J4 only surviving because of the Ghost Scepter for a second. But, oh my god, he actually is going to live through that.
Okay.
And Shaq actually picks up the kill. Cheshire Cat, though. He also lives. What the hell?
There's like three heroes that are just limping away with 10 HP.
I think A thought he was dead. He sort of went back in and he was like, oh, I was just at the right side of that last crypt swarm. And then the ghosts also just stopped. They were like, ooh, bye. Dire's top tower is under attack.
Well, another, I don't know. Is that a win?
Yes.
For Power Rangers? I mean, they got some kills, but...
No, it's definitely a win for Liquid in the fact that it was a dieback from the Spectra. Any item progression he could have faced in the next 5 minutes is gone completely.
Yeah. That could have been... That was an ideal circumstance. The sad part for PR is that they picked off a few heroes, they got the CK, and they easily could have lost three heroes on top of that. Like, that could have been a five-man team wipe. DP ult popped right in front of the tower. Could have just been game.
Once again, J4's Ice Blast just a bit off the mark.
That's so funny. His build is just... He's like, all right, I'm going to grab a gem and a Ghost Scepter, guys. He's a Quelling Blade and a Null.
Well, if they can push out far enough, they've actually got a couple of different wards here they can take out.
Oh, mighty Blitzkuhn. What is this Quelling Blade about?
It's so that you can dig deeper into the tree line so people don't find you. It's like you just, like, hide.
Oh, Matumba Man another hit by the one. Ice Blast. They get another pick off there. Attempted relocate in from Kuro to be able to save, but it's not going to work out.
Imagine if PR could have killed Fada right there in the earlier engagement when Kuro was super dead, but
yeah.
When he got healed up by the Darkseer at the last second.
They pop the ultimate for that one. There's no way that Illidan's going to be able to chase down Fada.
Oh, man.
Now, his item progression may not be going anywhere, but Shaq is recovering a bit. Thanks to all these kills that are happening, he's actually going to be able to pick up his Veil of Discord quite soon.
Things are still okay-ish. If the spec cannon bot back died, then they'd almost be in a salvageable position.
Still sort of lack of discipline from Liquid in the fact that they keep getting picked off despite being relatively close to each other. I'm a bit surprised that they let each other die like that. I mean, Kuro's trying his best to save them, but Matumba Man being caught out, we haven't seen Enchantress die as of recent. I think he learned his lesson when he was caught out entirely alone on the other side of the map.
Alright, so spec... What do you get here? Manta. Then get a defusal and just try to find nonstop. Team lineup is kind of working out.
He actually did go for the 20-minute Hand of Midas.
Did he? I know he would. The reason why is because it's in case the game continues to go, and he's not getting farm progression to begin with, so he has to do this. I know it sounds really stupid, and when I suggested it, it wasn't really a joke, just because you need to keep up with the rest of the group.
Oh, could this... Oh, man, if only... Oh, they still get the swap back. They have the double damage on Big Num, and that is enough damage. A pickup of two there from Power Rangers. A gigantic win for them.
All right.
I actually think the game has started to favor PR by this point. Spectre almost has either a Yasha into the Manta style or the Diffusal Blade. I'm assuming he's going to go for the Manta first for some survivability. Oh, there is the Yasha, sorry. And then, by then, as William was saying earlier, Spectre is one of the best late games, especially with this setup from PR. It really makes it easy for him.
Jerix knows he's dead.
And then, with the complete lack of farm on the Chaos Knight, it's really only Fader right now that has anything that resembles farm. And so I feel like Liquid is suddenly put on the clock. From being in the complete advantage of the game, they're now on a clock where they lost the option to push the base fairly easily just because of the levels that they've given out for and items they've given to PR now. So Zeus has 11, he has the Veil of Discord, and Spectra has sufficient farm to be a threat if they ever split up. The Nyx Assassin keeps on doing a ton of damage in these fights, really Chesercat being the standout player for me so far in the series from Power Rangers side of things. And then of course the AA ultimate, and when he's 11 as well, it's so difficult for Liquid to actually teamfight now.
I mean, Big Num's been owning too. He's always in the right position. And it's hard for Liquid to go into the high ground, as we've seen time and time again. You don't want to push up into AA ult, Zeus ult, Spectre ult. If you mess up one fight,
you could just throw the game around. So Liquid, they're going to go for the next objective, which is going
like
to be the Roshan.
I like this stat focus build on the four position Ventral Spirit. Treads, Ring of Aquila, drums. They're all kind of supporting items, but it does tank him up quite significantly.
I sort of would like to see him get a Force Staff. Mm-hmm. I think that would be the biggest item for him.
I was going to ask you if J4, if he goes for the Force Staff, that we see more
someone
combative
should.
AAs go, yeah. Or do you think the Ice Blast is necessary?
I think somebody should get one. Oh, okay. This is such a big fight. If they can win this one, this is the turnaround.
A couple smokes are popping. Cheshire Cat, they have the counter ward there. Fada is going to be one of the big targets here, but they're trying to go for Jerix first. A four-man South Zone. Fada's going to be able to get off his ultimate now. They turn around, jump on Cheshire Cat, easily kill him. J4, he managed to get off at least his Ice Blast, and Fada's a bit low, but there's too much chaos for really Power Rangers to do much. Spectre comes back in trying to fight this one out, but Fada's going to be able to survive. Shaq is going to be dying underneath the Tier 1 tower, and all they got out of that there was an Enchantress.
Man, that fight, by all means, was about to be amazing for PR, and then Fada just silences four targets, and the fight is completely turned around in Liquid's favor.
PR had to play so disciplined for this entire game just to come back, and they were doing a really good job of it, and in one fell swoop, all of that progress just goes away. That could have just been amazing for them. It looked like for a second, they know that the smoke was broken, but they ran into the Enchantress instead of the DP. Then the DP gets, like Jacob said, the four-man silence off. Everybody collapses on them, then they pincer themselves. Oh.
Like, it wasn't even this big ultimate coming out as we see from Earthshakers or even a global silence from a silencer. It was just a silence from Fader that completely destroyed PR in that fight. You just saw the AA blow up immediately, didn't get off anything. The Zeus being hunted out, couldn't do anything in a silence like that.
It was a positional game too. The Liquid, once the smoke broke, they saw them, and they're already coming and approaching from the left. And then you've had two heroes on the right. It made it too hard to hold on to. I think they lost their gem there too, right?
Yeah.
And again, this also happened in the previous game, how the marginals between Cheshire Cat and Fader in these engages where Cheshire Cat is about to set it up and Fader reacts. We saw it a lot on the Invoker against the Legion Commander. In this one, the Impale almost hit Fader, and had it, that fight might have gone, probably would have gone in PR's favor because he wouldn't have gotten off that silence.
PR really needed that fight because once Liquid starts to get BKBs, things, once you get one on your CK, things get really difficult.
Yeah, and they've already got some significant item pickups coming in. The Octarine Core is going to be here fairly soon for Death Prophet. That's obviously huge. And the Pipe as well for Mind Control. Looks like Matumbu is going to be able to pick up his BKB in the next couple of minutes as well. Power Rangers will have a lot of high ground defense if they can finish up this Aghanim Scepter on the Nyx Assassin.
He's got it. He's got fair levels too.
Particularly that mana burn is going to be really effective at defending against that Death Prophet's push.
What is the Enchantress's item progression?
She's almost got Axe. That's pretty big.
Yeah, but at what cost? She's completely skipped the Dragonlance. She's not really that buff, and she's playing up against an AA and Zeus, and as you were saying, the mana burn.
Comes gonna be immediately picked off here by the five man of Liquid.
You can't lose Shaq here. That's the big hero.
Yeah.
Venge is irrelevant.
You need both your Nyx Assassin and your Zeus to be able to play high ground here, but Liquid can do a little bit of split pushing here if they want to. They've got a nice little push at the top lane. Bottom's gonna pop his ultimate. Silence goes down.
It's StarCraft 2 time. Be the lurker.
He's going to jump forward a little bit farther before he burrows.
And then you just get silenced again. Okay, this is a little silly.
All right, Matumba Man. She's get the stun out. Those illusions are going to go down pretty fast. They're going to quickly pull back the burrow target, and they will be able to get Cheshire Cat. Illidan's jumped in trying to go for Curl, but there's too much damage, and now he's going to be surrounded by Matumba Man. Managed to get that Reality Rift pulled back, two down from Power Rangers, and they are completely defenseless now against Liquid's 5-man. Dire's top tower
is under attack. I'm sure that's not a thing in StarCraft. You can just pull him out like that.
This is so disappointing because it really just boiled down to that fight at bottom where this is just kind of completely swung around for them. It just feels like they've kind of lost a
a little bit too much. If they lose Shaq here too, they can't afford to lose their Zeus.
Oh, the swap. Get away, Matumba Man. Still trying to get that reality rest. Actually uses it on Big Num. Trying to get into the fountain. Big Num gets away. Doesn't have the swap yet to be able to punish.
He's still tanky. Like you talked about, that is, he did not go down easily. He got stunned and he still survived throughout four heroes.
Failed Discord, Jesus. Damage, Matumba Man tries to back himself away. Another great silence coming in from Fada. They get the stun onto Cheshire Cat. They're going to try and blow him up with a BKB. With a pullback, oh, the vacuum on four Power Rangers in some serious trouble now. As they're going to go for Big Num, pull him back in. Nice, Ice Blast. Maybe Illidan can clean up some heroes, though. Fada pops his BKB in response. Illidan's still going to try and hunt him down. Mind control's quite low as well. Shaq's trying to finish him up. Will be able to get one. Fada gets the TP away. And Matumba Man and Kuro going to be the next targets, though. Turn around. Oh, that's just an illusion. But the reality jump away, and Kuro gets them back to the fountain.
Still, the PR is kind of holding. It's costing them more than they would like. At the same time, for some reason, the Zeus just continues to hold on, but he brings back the CK.
They actually have the CK fighting up against Illidan. He's still trying to go for Kuro. Pops the Manta in order for a bit of confusion. Now turns on a Matumba Man. Matumba Man isolated there. Gets wrecked by the Desolate damage.
Not just that. Zeus as well. Zeus has now gotten the level that he needs to really deal efficiently with these high health targets.
Let it go. Let it go. If he had let it go there and it passed through and hit Kuro.
He's got Glimmer.
That's true.
They got the gem back, though. And more importantly, the streak went on to the Spectre, right? Who's the one that got the last hit?
Yeah. Spectre got the mega kill. 801 gold out of that.
It's really important for them to continue to have hopes in this game.
And Shaq actually got a lot of gold out of the Darkseer as well. 818.
They've been so close to ending this game a few times. If in the original assault, if they had killed the Zeus before he got swapped by the Venge at the last second, he was dead. He had 300 HP. They had the lock on him. Then the Venge swaps. Doesn't even die for that. They buy enough time for the Spectre to survive. They went all in to kind of kill the Zeus so that even if the Spec's alive, he's their main damage dealer. But because he was able to survive, a little bit too hard to go high ground.
Do you think that defusal, like normally, and probably in this case as well, we'll see the defusal pick up from the Spectre now being the natural item progression. But if you have looked at these team fights, the burst damage coming out from Liquid is so lackluster that if he went for additional survivability, because the damage output is already there, but if he can actually tank through these engagements against Team Liquid, don't you think that PR would much easier win these fights? Like, he's going for the defusal now to probably, like, try and kill out these targets in a faster pace, obviously. But if he went straight for the heart, I think there is little Liquid can do to actually take him down.
I think he would lack for damage, though. I think he needs to be... I kind of agree with you because he needs to be the frontliner for the Zeus, but I also think he lacks damage. It's one of those scenarios where you're just a little bit far behind, so you have to make a decision between the two. I can kind of agree, though. You can make an argument for either.
I think they have plenty of damage output in the Zeus and the AA, and then with him, as soon as he isolates a target, Desolate in itself is just, you know...
Oh, this is the setup.
Oh, no! They managed to get the Yule Scepter! He's still going to be able to get the Kleps there on Fada. Maybe they can finish him off with some physical damage, but oh, a great vacuum wall! They managed to get a great impale on top of the Cheshire Cat sitting on the side here. Illidan's going to be able to clean up a couple, but he's still going to go down. Shaq trying to pop. Oh, nice relocate out there. Kuro was definitely going to die in that situation. And it looks like he still will. Recovery of the gem once again. Cheshire Cat. Well, what are they doing here? All right, so the push back in
a lot of ways, I felt like that was the best kind of initiate Liquid could have hoped for, and it still went 3-for-3.
If PR had held the spec there, that would have been massive for them.
Fortunately, he did manage to keep a bit of reliable gold on himself.
At least they saved the Zeus. The Zeus is doing disproportionate damage to how much he's tanky. He goes down pretty quickly, but they just haven't been able to get on top of him.
Yeah, between the Aether Lens and the Blink Dagger, he's got to be a hard target to shut down.
Yeah, and the Ghost Scepter against the CK. And he's really the answer to how to take down the Death Prophet and the CK. It's not even the Spectre, and this falls back on me saying he just needs to tank up at this point. Because once he has enough tank ability, he'll survive through these team fights. He'll get the gold gain, and then he can easily follow up with the damage build. When he's going for this defusal play, there's a high risk involved in the fact that he might go down every team fight. They might lose the game before he'll even get to any other tank items because of it. It's sort of a more of an all-in play, and I just like to play it safe.
What would your item be, Jacob? Is it BKB? Or do you like...
No, I don't think he needs to BKB, because even though Liquid has great gap closing in Reality Rift and mm-hmm. Surge and Tether, it's they severely lack lockdown. And if you build into hard, of course the item progression is a lot harder than just going for the defusal. But even then, the Vitality Booster, 250 HP against the lineup of Liquid that already has issues dealing with the Vengeful Spirit, I think that would suffice.
It's weird. It's like a 12k lead, I think, by Liquid, and they still haven't taken Arax. How often do you see a lead like this that hasn't developed into anything else? And it's just because, again, PR have really sick high ground defense heroes.
One of the main reasons I brought up BKB is if Illidan has BKB, he could actually just go straight for the Enchantress every time.
No, I don't think that you just go for BKB up. In this situation. They have enough burst damage between their Zeus and Nyx.
Yeah, definitely. Enchantress is not even an issue here. It's definitely just the Chaos Knight that they want to either kill off or get sufficiently low so the fans have not playing any kind of role at all. And then the Death Prophet. You do not want to get sucked into her realm of ghosts and spirit siphons. So it's...
Oh, Shishikat gonna burrow here. They actually have to set up on fire. They're gonna blow him up. Double kill there. Beautiful setup. The fight's still gonna go on in the background, but it looks like Power Rangers should be able to overcome. Big Numb with a nice swap in. Mind Control's almost done for. They're gonna be able to run him down. And Matumba Man, without much help, isn't gonna be able to finish this off. 3 seconds down on Illidan, but he can't commit. He's got no mana whatsoever. And he's just gonna be run down eventually.
Look at this. This is a CK with 3 core items that struggles to take down a Vengeful Spirit in Phantasm. This is how much Liquid is now struggling with dealing out enough damage.
Oh, Shaq, he's locked down Curl.
He's got Glimmer.
Boots are traveled in, blink forward. And even that Glimmer, as long as he can maybe keep eyes on where Curl is heading to.
Yeah,
inside the Roshan pit. Curl trying to get to the Nine from Roshan, does successfully get it, but
this Roshan's gonna
he
go
does
down
lead
so
Power
fast.
Rangers straight to Roshan.
And a full team wipe with only AA going down for PR. I think this is now PR's game to lose, actually.
I sort of think so, too. Like that's what we were talking about, is that if you look at Liquid's lineup, they just had to kill the Zeus at some point during the high ground pushes, but they were just never able to. They were so close a few times, and you saw them almost overextend just to do it because they realized the urgency of the matter, but PR is just holding on over and over again.
Yeah, and Spectre now has the Aegis, so that the next team fight he'll actually live through. He already amassed enough gold to almost pick up a Reaver, so at this point in time, the gamble paid off, so to speak, the Diffusal Blade. They won this team fight that was so crucial, because had it gone the other way around, had Liquid won, Spectre wouldn't have any gold progression, he wouldn't even have buyout gold, mm-hmm. and Liquid could have kept on keeping him low in these team fights and probably killing him off in every team fight. Now it's going to go the entirely different route. He's going to have enough gold to tank up and make it even harder for Liquid to kill him. And at this point, Liquid needs to, like, the problem for PI is they still have a long ways to go to actually break high ground on their own. So they can still hope to pick off the Spectre later in the stages of the game.
That setup from the Nyx at top was so sweet.
Yeah, and it all comes back to them taking away the gem from the previous fight. Yeah.
That fight
wasn't the case.
That was incredible, yeah. The way that he set that up. He gets in behind both of them, then Mind Control's going to be the target
Spectre
here.
Spectre Ultimate, nope. Yeah, they got Jax.
Doesn't matter, though. They're getting so much out of this.
Yeah, and you just can't split up if you're Liquid. You haven't been able to at any point in time in this game, and it's only getting worse now that Spectre can actually just haunt and go for any isolated target on his own. He doesn't even need the backup of the Nyx Assassin.
And because of the co-scepters that PR have, there's no burst damage from Liquid in terms of magic nukes. What do they have? Like, the best thing that they have is Death Prophet's nuke. It's almost nothing. They can't afford to lose Mind Control here.
Found another one. Mind Control's going to go down before anything goes off. Matumba Man, they relocated him in. He's going to be able to turn on a Big Nut, but that's not a major kill. Mind Control comes back into this fight after
you
a
need
buyback.
To kill Shaq.
Shaq, they're trying to lock him down. They manage to get the Soul Siphon to slow him down, blocking him out, but the Ice Blast is going to come in over the top. Still, though, there's just not enough damage. Power Rangers have backed themselves away. Shishir Cat still no. Oh, they finally get a dust. Shishir Cat realizing he actually doesn't want to be sitting out here. Oh, Ghost pullback, and they've got him. Illidan showing himself for a second, probably hoping if maybe he can snatch the gem, but that's not going to be the case.
That CK is stupid fast. He's got to get out of there. Yeah. Finally, a successful fight for Liquid, and PR just way overextended. The angle in which they took that fight was so weird.
In between Tier 1 and Tier 2, I mean, if the Darkseer doesn't have buyback there, you know, it could have gone perfectly fine for Power Rangers, but...
Wisp is just not a good target for the Nyx Assassin to focus on either. It really needs to be the Death Prophet or even the Darkseer. Because Darkseer is so disruptive in these teamfights, and all the damage output is almost exclusively through the Death Prophet. Bar, of course, the Phantasm from CK that has been spent on killing Bignum on the Vengeful Spirit in almost every teamfight.
That's good, though, for PR. They're incredibly happy that the majority of the CK usage is just onto that Vengeful Spirit. The only downside right now for... the biggest downside for that fight was just that they couldn't line up anything. In the previous fights that had been successful for them, they had been able to set the tone of the fight. They had full vision. They had an open area to work with. But this time around, the AA wasn't really sure where the fight was going to take place. He wasn't really close enough to set that up. And on top of that, the angle was just weird. You didn't have the best vision on top of like J4 not really being ready for that.
So at this point in time, the Midas on Matumba Man has actually paid off dividends by now. He got the Black King bar, he's now built a Halberd, and he has a Reaver on him as well. So 3,000 HP Phantasm Illusions. They might still have a chance, because it's so difficult for PR's lineup to deal with these. Outside of the Zeus, there's no real answer to these Phantasm Illusions.
Freshly picked up Shiva's by Fada. It's going to slow down Illidan, but he doesn't really seem to care. He's just going to keep going towards Fada. They do have the Ice Blast coming in. It is going to be able to hit both. Mind Control is definitely going down here. And now Cheshire Cat burrows on in. Will be able to hit the stun on Fada, slowing him down. Instant kill. Matumba Man in the back. He'll be able to get Shaq and still has his ultimate ready to go. BKB going out. He's going to try and target Illidan down, but Illidan seems to be too much for him to be able to handle. Another great stun from Cheshire Cat pops out. Matumba Man just getting kited around. Even if he is killing some of the supports and the squishy heroes in the back, he's going to go down eventually without a save from somebody. Matumba Man, 400 HP. That's all that's left. And Illidan will finally be able to get the kill off of his dispersion.
And Illidan is playing so aggressive because he knows he has that Aegis of the Immortal. It's going to expire soon. And he can just afford to frontline now. He has the Heart of Tarrasque. There's nothing Liquid can actually do to take him down, even if they focused him with the Phantasm. And you saw Matumba Man was even hesitant to do so, knowing that Dispersion might actually end up killing the entire ultimate right off the bat. So I just don't see them have an answer to the Spectre anymore.
Cheshire Cat still has the blink, but he blinks away.
They have to take a fight correctly. The Liquid has to... I don't know. Liquid has so many weird conditions. Like, Fada can't get hit by the AA Blast.
Oh, nice hit.
That is
unfortunately not a Ags upgrade.
Zeus,
and he's got
he
Glimmer
up?
Cape, so... No.
No.
5 seconds. Radiant's middle tower not going to be enough. Attack. Tries it anyway, but...
All right.
Come on, sprites. Not even close.
I guess that's fine.
That was a terrible idea.
It was pretty weird. I guess it's worth it though, right? The risk reward there. You lose the cooldown, but you potentially pick up a pretty big target. Is that a gem on the Enchantress? Is that what you saw?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm sure PR has, like, by the time he ulted, they realized they were not going to teamfight within the next minute or so because of Nyx being out of mana, Spectre having just TP'd home to farm.
I like this Dragonlance pickup. Though, I kind of like, Ethan Lens, less so on Vengeful Spirit ever since the change where it no longer gets that magic resistance.
Blade Mail, Dragonlance.
Vengeful Spirit is kind of turning into a bit of a right-click semi-carry.
This is like the weirdest core build.
I mean, I really like and respect Bignum for showing this ingenuity in his item build. Not just going for, you know... I don't even know what he would pick up, but the Blade Mail Dragonlance, how often do you see a support hero with this kind of inventory?
Mm-hmm. It's kind of working out, but I almost feel like...
The Dragonlance might be a bit of a misstep. I feel like it is kind of a jumping item, though, because he can very reasonably think, I can push this game late enough, I can also get BKB if he breaks it apart. BKB and Butterfly, both, I think, would be valuable on a semi-carry bench.
I guess. That's kind of the idea of why Matumba Man decides to go for the Midas on CK, because he understands that the game, I think Liquid understood really quickly. They're like, okay, we can't break high ground. It's really difficult for us. And if I just decide to go for an all-in BKB and we don't win the fight and the Spectre continues to scale, then the game's over.
It's not just that, but what other item at around 2k gold would benefit him more? I mean, you could argue that a mechanism would be decent in the team fights, but at this point in time, they're not really struggling with survivability anyways. And Dragonlance, the stats that it gives for a Vengeful Spirit at this point in time for 1900 gold, is definitely worthwhile. You get the Ogre Club, and then you have the attack speed coming out. and of course the attack range. And by this point in time, she deals over 200 damage just because of her aura as well. I think it's a really good item.
I feel like everybody should just go Ghost Scepter on PR's team. It pays off so much against Liquid's lineup. No magic burst whatsoever to speak of. What are you going to be worried about? The majority of the damage comes from the Ghost or the CK.
Yeah, if you could just kite around the CK because that damage is so dependent on Reality Rift.
What are the BKB charges at? Like 5 seconds respectively for both the course of Liquid? It has to be.
Yeah, probably. Matumba Man, five seconds there.
The DP then definitely has to be because she got a third item.
Yeah, she got it way early.
Yeah, so you go for Ghost Scepter here. What can they do? You just last out the BKB timers, then you re-engage and destroy them. The situation has become pretty dire.
Power Rangers. Seeing if they can get a sneaky little fight entrance from the side. Spectre Ultimate, Zeus Ultimate going out. Ice Blast is just barely going to be able to clip Fada, but they're actually going for more on the right-hand side. It looks like Shishikana trying to stall up Matumba Man. They're going to try and focus down that Burrow target, and they will be able to get him, but Fada is taken out by Illidan, and I can't see that being a good trade. Now this is the Vacuum in. They have a lot of illusions, Bignums being the target, but he's managing to just kite them around the trees. They pull back Illidan, but he's the tanky one, and that's not going to matter one bit. Oh, the swap back. Bignum very bravely trying to save Illidan, but Illidan, not sure if he needed the saving there. He managed to get a bit of heart regen coming back in. Matumba Man is going to be stunned up by the Cold Feet proc, and he's, I think, done for. Curl's going to be able to provide the Glimmer Cape, and never mind. Illidan is going to be forced back. Managed to dodge that last impetus shot, but 36 to 35, 45 minutes in. The game very even now between Liquid and Power Rangers.
Super messy fight, and I think in parts because both Illidan and Chesuket wasted a lot of time doing nothing. Chesuket ran all around the Liquid lineup trying to find out the Darkseer, and then Illidan mistakenly hit the Enchantress three times, thinking that she was hit by the AA blast, but she wasn't, so she wasn't going to go down, because there's no way the Spectre's ever going to deal enough damage for her to go down. Mm-hmm.
They're going to push without their DP, but this might be one of their better opportunities.
Without the Phantasm from the Matumba Man as well. And yeah, Power Rangers just going to take full advantage of this fight. Vacuum, they get a 4 seconds done onto Shaq. They manage to take out Jarex here, and finally the Ghost Scepter goes off. Matumba Man has to transfer targets, but most of the targets are Ghost Scepter. The Ice Blast hits him. They get the stun. Matumba Man desperately needs saving here, but Curl can't provide. He's got no relocate out, and Illidan will take the kill. Last but not least, Mind Control goes down as well, and the push uphill without the Death Prophet turns to be potentially Liquid's big downfall.
That value pickup by Illidan too. The Talisman of Evasion, you saw it pay off multiple times. He was getting spear chucked by the Enchantress, mm-hmm. and he even got four staff, and I was like, that spear's going to do 1,000 damage. Completely misses. Right, the situation is... this game is unreal. If you're Liquid, you think to yourself, you know that you're up 15K, and you think to yourself, okay, we're pretty far ahead. We've got the pressure on them at all times. We've destroyed the Zeus's early game, and now it turns into this. Like, Cheshire Cat's massive. You can't kill him easily. The Spectre is incredibly difficult to deal with. Shaq can be in the middle of the fight, but because you have zero burst damage, you can't take him out. You saw, they isolated him. He didn't even have the Ghost Scepter on. They got the CK stun off. They had everybody attacking him, and he still didn't die.
And you gotta be especially annoyed if you're Liquid right now. You gotta be pulling your own hair, right? Because you didn't have the stones to just gather up and push at the 20-minute mark. It all stems back from the fact that they had this huge 10k lead at the 20-minute mark. They had a lineup that they could very well push with. There was no item and level progression on PR that could have kept them out of the base if they hadn't been picked off in these horrible situations that they kept on being.
Power Rangers now going to be the ones massively on the offensive. Got Cheshire Cat once again trying to set things up, sneaking around behind the Tier 2 tower. Seeing if he can find easy, quick kill. And he just might with this ward. He's going to be able to see two. Blinks into them. Turns around. Gets the stun on the bolt. But the relocate is here. And Cheshire Cat in some serious trouble. Gets off the spike carapace. Hoping to be able to blink away eventually. They do manage to get the Zeus ultimate out. They're going to try and finish out the darts here. Meanwhile, Illidan's come in. They've got Jarex as well. Yeah, they managed to take down. Oh, they didn't even get the Nyx Assassin there. Illidan, he's running down Fada now with the Ice Blast on top of him. Rest of his team trying to catch up desperately. Meanwhile, inside the base, they managed to get Matumba Man back over to Fada. He will be able to make the escape. It looks like no, Cheshire Cat actually wants this, and he wants it bad. He's got the Blink Dagger forward. Oh, Jesus! 680 Ouch. Damage straight to the face. Death Prophet goes down. That's a wipe with Power Rangers losing basically nothing there. How did the Nyx Assassin end up surviving?
They have no damage. They just can't kill anybody.
There is zero burst on Liquid's lineup.
They just the window is ended. Radiant, they got the stun off. Then he spike carapaces and just runs away. This is how confident PR are. They're like, what is the point of Rax? Come on, guys.
They know no buybacks have come out yet. Fada's going to be the one to pop the first buyback, but that's the only one they have.
I think at this point in time, bar a reality rift on the Spectra into the fountain, he could actually just zone them out by standing on the other side of the throne.
Cheshire Cat desperately trying to get underground, but that's not going to happen. Fada on the front lines with the BKB, but he's all by himself. That Desolate damage is coming into play. The Ice Blast, he quickly goes down. The stun on Jerix, and that is going to be another two down. Power Rangers buying back, coming back in. Four-man vacuum, but no wall follow-up as Nyx Assassin was able to get the stun first. Mind Control is now going to throw down the wall, but it doesn't make a damn difference. Curl's still going to go down. Most of Power Rangers still looking decently healthy, and the throne still exposed. That's going to be the end of the game, and a tie for Team Liquid, who had such good control in this game number two, but faltered going into the mid-game.
I know a lot of people are going to immediately point to this game and say it's a throw, but I just think that PR executed their lineup really well. The fact that they were able to keep the Zeus alive at all times, like, really big props to Bignum, because he understands every single time. He's like, okay, the target to save isn't the Spectre, it's the Zeus. I'm going to save my swap for the Zeus. Anytime Shaq gets out of position, I'm going to make sure that he survives. And Shaq had a miraculous comeback. Somehow he goes from being level 4 at 11 minutes into the game to doing something like this. They just spaced their lineup really well. Then Cheshire Cat was finally able to get online. And that's what we said in the early game repeatedly. It was, this game does not really start until all the heroes hit level 6. Once you get your AA ult online, your Zeus ult online, your Nyx can kind of go around the map. Then you can start thinking about the game.
And Power Rangers, who were really fighting for pride here, definitely showed that some of the weakness that they had early on in the Dota pit, that they aren't without some glimmer of his hope. They're going to end their run in the group with 5 different points. That's going to tie up with Hellraisers. But really, this doesn't mean too much for most of the teams. Team Liquid, however, with this tie will jump up to 6 points. But what they really need is a win. That's going to be their next match against Tornado Rocks. If either one of those two teams manages to take a win of clean 2-0 in the series, they will tie up with Team Empire for first in the slot, and we'll have a tiebreaker to determine who's going to be moving on. But if it ends up in a draw, Team Empire naturally take that first place slot with 9 points. So this is going to be quite the interesting grid. Jacob, what do you think about Power Rangers?
I'm really impressed by, as Will was saying, Bignum. And then Cheshire Cat, I think, has always been the standout performer on their lineup. I think he's by far the saving grace. After they added Illidan, though, you could say that they've actually gotten so much premier talent on the roster that they can upset some of the better teams, which we just saw. But I think in large part, it's also, I think if you're Fader, you're going to be especially annoyed with how this game played out.
I just think that Liquid could have played this game a little bit cleaner. Like, picking up an earlier gem and neutralizing the Nyx might have been the route to go, because Cheshire Cat got way too much out of this game. I just don't think they were well equipped to deal with him, but I think that PR executed the lineup really well. This is the second time I've seen them get stomped in game one and then turn around and have a game two like this where they just kind of battle it back, because I think when they have to play lineups like this where they have to just hold the bend not break style, this is kind of where they're the most successful.
All right, guys. Well, that brings a close to Dota Pit for the night, as we're talking about. It is going to be a draw between these two teams. More Dota Pit action is going to be coming up. Obviously, the big match is going to be Tornado Rocks versus Team Liquid. I'm actually not sure when that's going to be scheduled, but I'm sure it'll be soon. In the meantime, you guys can check out all of us at Dota Capitalist, at Blitz Dota, and at The Milk.
There's an underscore, by the way.
I know, Blitz underscore Dota. You probably follow him anyway, but if you appreciate Jacob coming back into Dota 2,
The Milk,
maybe give him a little bit of love. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Hope you guys appreciate it, and we'll see you guys next week.